We'll start. Let me first give you the objective of the session. I will be taking 5 to 6 topics of economics. After me, Jatin sir would be taking 5 to 6 topics. Tomorrow there is a lecture on IR. Ruchika ma'am would be taking that topic, and then after that, Smriti ma'am would be taking topic on social issues. Okay, so this is the program for 2 days. Today I will be taking the following topics: Make in India, labor reforms, NPA, bankruptcy bill and code. Startup India and SECC. Jatin would take the following topics. Would be taking a gold monetization scheme, 14th Finance Commission, issue with respect to pulses, Skill India, two more topics I am not able to recall, power sector in India, one more topic I think. So this is like the plan for today. So most of you got a call. Okay, so congratulations for crossing the second hurdle. I think just one step more. No? Okay, so like our objective is specifically with respect to people who are preparing for the interview. So what the nature of discussion would be a bit different from what used to be in the current affairs classes. I will try to pose a lot of questions which are probable questions with respect to such issues. Okay, I will be giving you some facts which you could use to formulate an opinion, to formulate your argument. And other than that, we would mostly talk about various programs of the Government of India, because it has been seen year over year that in interview most of the questions which are like asked from these sections, like international relations or economics, they are from programs of Government of India. Okay, so I think so let's start. So these are the topic that I would be taking today. Okay, let's first start with Make in India. Okay, so like this particular logo, you know, matlab questions with respect to interview could be anything. If someone is a mechanical engineer, theek hai, a very simple question could be asked that in the Make in India logo you could see what are the components of the logo. Theek hai, so when you see the logo, there are various gears, pulleys, okay, which are there in the logo. Okay, so such type of questions are also asked many a times, ki how a lever is different from a pulley, why gears are there in the Make in India logo. So please go back, have a see ki why the logo is as that. Now the most prominent question if we think from an interview perspective is, they will say ki why, like why do we want Make in India, why we are having a Make in India campaign in the very first place. It is like our Prime Minister has said that it is one of the biggest brands currently of India. Okay, why do we need such a brand? Why the whole government is focusing so much on Make in India? ठीक है. सो वेरी सिंपल क्वेश्चन, बट यू नीड टू अंडरस्टैंड, यू नीड यू यू कुड गिव टू और थ्री आर्ग्यूमेंट्स वेरी प्रिसाइज वेरी टर्स दैट द ग्रोथ विच हैपेंड पोस्ट 1991 इज मेनली सर्विस सेक्टर लेड ग्रोथ. ठीक है. इफ यू सी द डिफरेंशियल, इफ यू सी द डिफरेंशियल बिटवीन परसेंटेज कंट्रीब्यूशन टू जीडीपी एंड परसेंटेज ऑफ एम्प्लॉयमेंट टू वेरियस सेक्टर्स, देन यू कुड फाइंड द रीजन व्हाई मेक इन इंडिया. सो टू थ्री वेरी प्रोमिनेंट रीजन. फर्स्ट इज मैन्युफैक्चरिंग सेक्टर. इट इज जनरली सेड मैन्युफैक्चरिंग सेक्टर इज लेबर इंटेंसिव. ओके. सो as our prime minister says, what is the most prominent thing that India has? Can any one of you tell me? So talk in his terms. What do we have? 3 Ds. Democracy, demand, and demographic dividend. Here you have to understand why he is also asking or saying demand. Further, when we will take up arguments with respect to make in India and make for India, which our Governor Raghuram Rajan talked about, then we would be better able to appreciate the role of this demand. This demographic dividend, if we don't have the jobs, if we are not able to absorb them in the labor market, then what will happen? Rather than a dividend, it will become a disaster. Just one recent example, you must have heard about the protest which happened 4 days before in Haryana. So what are the protests? Some of the scholars, they are saying that there are a number of youth who are just sitting idle. They have BTech degrees, they have educational qualifications, but they don't have a job. So one of the prominent demand for reservation is reservation in schools, higher educational institutions, and reservation in jobs. So people want job. Okay. So where would the job come from? Thereby such a huge emphasis on the manufacturing sector. Thereby comes the Make in India campaign. So coming forward, what we will talk about, we will talk about what is Make in India, because it is very important in interview that whenever the panel asks you what is Make in India, whenever the panel asks you what is Make in India, you need to be very terse. Please go through the definition of Make in India. It is a program of the Government of India. I will just come to the definition, but please just read it by heart and tell it in a very precise and terse manner. Then why Make in India? We will go about it. We will have some data, some facts to substantiate our point. Then we will come in the third point, that what are the policies under the Make in India initiative. What is its current status? This year, this is very important. Since the program was launched year back, okay, now whenever the panel asks, you have to substantiate using various facts. Maybe let's say ease of doing business, maybe amount of FDI. There are other indices on the basis of which you could say ki yes, there has been something on the ground, or is it just a campaign? So what I would suggest is ki always be positive. It is such a big campaign. Please highlight the positive aspects of the campaign. See what has been done on the ground until now. I will give you certain facts regarding this. Then what are the challenges to its implementation? Ki bhai kyon nahi ho pa raha hai? Still a lot of private investments, they are not able to take off. What is the problem? Further, last year also a lot of people or a lot of questions were asked from this front. Make in India versus make for India. So let's first start the Make in India campaign. What is Make in India? It is an initiative launched to encourage companies to increase manufacturing in India. What are its aims? It aims at increasing the GDP and tax revenues in the country by producing products that meet high quality standards and minimizing the impact on environment. This is also very important. Maybe in the next slide I will tell you why this line is important, that is minimizing the impact of impact on environment. You must have heard of this acronym, no? Zero defect. Zero effect. Then the Make in India program is also about fostering innovation, protecting intellectual property and enhancing skill development. Theek hai? Why we are talking about fostering innovation? Here one thing you need to understand is that one point is that it's just a manufacturing hub. That is R&D etc is done in a developed nation. You are just producing, for example, Apple. ठीक है, एवरीथिंग R&D, एवरीथिंग इज डन इन US, द प्रोडक्शन यूनिट्स आर इन चाइना. ठीक है, इन दैट सिस्टम दो यू आर प्रोड्यूसिंग बट यू आर नॉट एबल टू रीप द रिच डिविडेंस विच कम आउट ऑफ इट. Thereby वी आर ऑल्सो ट्राइंग टू फोकस ऑन इनोवेशन सो दैट लार्ज कंपनीज दे ऑल्सो सेटअप देयर R&D डिविजन इन इंडिया. Protecting intellectual property, I think you all know very well. Intellectual property, the government has set up a committee. It will come out with certain guidelines. Enhancing skill development, Skill India campaign, you all know, I think. Jatin sir, who is taking class after this, he will talk more about the Skill India campaign. Further, the program lays emphasis on 25 sectors with focus on job creation and skill enhancement. ठीक है, now out of this 25 sectors, you could prioritize. That what are the sectors in which there is huge, which has huge capability to build in India. For example, the defense sector. So you must have heard that a lot of indigenous government is bringing some policy to evolve the indigenous sectors, indigenous defense sector in India. Further, with respect to like railways, you must have heard that Alstom, they had a contract with railways for building engines for railways. So such kind of highlights you could give. Now coming to the next part, why do we want to have a Make in India campaign? Because our business environment, it is very difficult to conduct business in India. So what is our current ranking on ease of doing business? 130. What it was in 2014-15? So initially it was 142. Further they revised it to 134. So it is very difficult to start and do business in India. Thereby we are in this campaign which is emphasizing on de-licensing, deregulation, very first aspect. Second is that this only will not lead to Make in India. You need to provide infrastructure. So infrastructure development is again one of the very important points with respect to manufacturing in India. Because let me give you an example. If there is no electricity, will any foreign investor will come and set up a plant in India? No. You must also see this in a holistic perspective with respect to what is happening in India, example in highway sector or in port sector. We have schemes like Sagarmala project. We are talking about building special economic zones in coastal areas. Okay, why? Because it is very easy then. If you like set up SEZs here, it is very easy to export to other nations. Okay, so see the Make in India campaign in a very holistic perspective. 25 focus sectors, try to see what are the sectors in which India could take a lead. Defense is one of them. Tourism is one of them in which is labor intensive, where you could have a lot of labor which could be undertaken. Railways is one of them, ports is one of them. Pharmaceutical, we are already doing very good. स्पेस अगेन ऑटोमोबाइल्स ऑटोमोबाइल्स ऑलरेडी वी आर अहेड. इलेक्ट्रिकल इंडस्ट्री इज वन सच इंडस्ट्री वेयर वी आर डूइंग वेरी गुड. इवन इन 2015 वी हैड अ रिकॉर्ड जनरेशन ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिसिटी इन इंडिया. फर्दर यू ऑल्सो हैव टू सी दिस इंपॉर्टेंट कंपोनेंट दैट इन 2013 इंडियाज मैन्युफैक्चरिंग सेक्टर कंट्रीब्यूटेड ओनली 13% टू नेशनल जीडीपी. Whereas if you see this percentage contribution of GDP, especially like with respect to China, it is huge. Then what are the policies like? Okay, Make in India campaign is good. Everyone knows, okay, Make in India. But what is Make in India? What are the policies that the government is bringing forward? Okay, so firstly, the government is trying to do something with respect to ease of doing business. That how to improve the ease of doing business. De-licensing, deregulation. The initial form that you have to fill to register an entity, simplifying labor laws, providing skill to the people, bringing FDI, intellectual property rights, which is again a very important component, manufacturing. What is our goal? Our goal is to increase its share from 16% to 25% by 2022. Sectoral growth, that is the growth of manufacturing sector, to 12 to 14% per annum over the medium term. And we also think of creating 100 million additional job by 2022. And the last, I think this is special with respect to environment sustainability. That is, we want to create such units which don't pollute the environment. Okay, thereby we are saying zero defect, zero effect. Zero effect on the environment. Moving forward,
sir, how to ensure this last point, zero defect?
See, it is like with respect to you could say Bharat stage norms. What we have said, we will directly jump from BS4 to BS6. Okay, this is one such initiative. Other than that, whatever industries we are bringing, we will ask them to have technology which is not polluting the environment, or if polluting, polluting in a minimal way. That is what, if in our philosophy only, we will talk that we don't want industries which pollute the environment. Okay, because one of the major criticism of manufacturing sector is that it is it produces a lot of waste products. Okay, so we have very well said that we want those industries that we are, which are very less polluting, so that we could take care of our environment. Now, what are its challenges to implementation? ठीक है, तो सबसे पहला चैलेंज कि let's see, you set up an industry in India, but if you don't have people who have those skills, then what is the point? So a Skill India campaign is very well needed if we want to succeed the Make in India campaign. ठीक है, तो सी मेक इन इंडिया कैंपेन, अगेन आई एम टेलिंग दिस, दिस इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट इन अ वेरी हॉलिस्टिक मैनर, बिकॉज एवरीथिंग विल अगेन कन्वर्ज इन मेक इन इंडिया. हाउ? लेट्स टेक ऑल द कैंपेन्स ऑफ गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया. स्किल इंडिया कैंपेन, अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट पार्ट. लेबर रिफॉर्म्स, अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट पार्ट ऑफ मेक इन इंडिया, यू कुड से. Then Digital India campaign, it could also be linked to Make in India campaign. Infrastructural development, in which everything comes, like road sector, railways, then ports. Then we are also talking about inland waterways. So the government has come up with new schemes. Aviation sector, further electricity generation, so all these are interrelated, especially with respect to Make in India. Even you could talk about cooperative and competitive federalism. Why? Because आपने देखा होगा कि now every state is having their own annual day, you could say, for business summits, for attracting investment. तो इवन दिस कॉम्पिटिटिव फेडरलिज्म यू कुड ऑल्सो रिलेट विथ मेक इन इंडिया कैंपेन. नाउ कमिंग बैक टू हियर, लाइक वट आर द चैलेंजेस टू इम्प्लीमेंटेशन, यू कुड सी एवरीथिंग हेयर एंड हेयर इज सेम. मल्टीपल टैक्सेशन, द गवर्नमेंट सेड दैट वी विल ब्रिंग आउट अ सुटेबल, वी विल ब्रिंग आउट अ स्टेबल टैक्स मैकेनिज्म, बट स्टिल इफ यू मस्ट हैव हर्ड लाइक 5 days बिफोर दे सेंट अ नोटिस टू वोडाफोन फॉर रिकवरी ऑफ टैक्सेस. ओके, बट अगेन अवर प्राइम मिनिस्टर हैज सेड दैट टैक्स टेररिज्म, विच वॉज अ टर्म विच वॉज कॉइंड ड्यूरिंग द यूपीए रेजीम, ठीक है, द गवर्नमेंट इज सेइंग दैट वी विल नॉट गो फॉर दैट, वी विल हैव अ वेरी स्टेबल पॉलिसी विथ रेस्पेक्ट टू टैक्सेशन इन इंडिया. लेबर लॉस, अगेन आई विल बी टेकिंग लेबर लॉस इन अ सेपरेट, एज अ सेपरेट टॉपिक. लैंड एक्विजिशन अगेन इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. यू ऑल नो वट हैपन टू 2013 द यूपीए गवर्नमेंट ब्रॉट अ लॉ, द एनडीए गवर्नमेंट अगेन, सॉरी द बीजेपी गवर्नमेंट अगेन ब्रॉट एन अमेंडमेंट टू दिस लॉ, बट देन दे हैव टू टेक इट बैक. देन इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चरल कंस्ट्रेंट, स्टिल वी हैव अ लॉट ऑफ स्टेट्स वेयर द इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर इज नॉट अप टू द मार्क. इफ वी टॉक अबाउट द पोर्ट्स इन इंडिया, देन द टर्न अराउंड टाइम ऑफ शिप इज ह्यूज. स्टिल वी डोंट हैव अ पोर्ट विच कुड हैंडल द बिग साइज, व्हाट यू कुड से, कार्गो, बिग साइज कार्गो, और जो बड़ी वाली शिप्स आती हैं कि काफ़ी बड़ी, वी डोंट हैव दैट एबिलिटी इन अवर पोर्ट टू हैंडल दो शिप. सो व्हाट हैपेंस दैट फर्स्ट दे आइदर गो टू कोलंबो और दे गो टू सिंगापुर, दे बर्थ माल उतरता है, फिर वो छोटी शिप में डलता है, फिर वो छोटी शिप इंडिया लेके आती है, ठीक है. देयर बाय यू मस्ट हैव हर्ड दैट विजिंगम इन केरला, द गवर्नमेंट हैज साइंड एन एमओयू विद अदानी ग्रुप टू डेवलप दिस पोर्ट फॉर दिस स्पेसिफिक पर्पस. ओके, फर्दर दिस अगेन इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट प्रॉब्लम विद रेस्पेक्ट टू एमएसएमई सेक्टर्स इन इंडिया, बिकॉज इफ यू सी large industries in manufacturing sector, they are becoming more and more capital intensive, theek hai, then where would the jobs come from? So the job would come from this MSME sector. Now one last point with respect to this, this is many times asked ki like what is the difference between like make in India and make for India? Can anyone of you tell me? To consume in the country. Why? मतलब why do we say that no, we don't want make in India but make for India?
Because there is generally downtrend in the world economy and similar trend is also seen in the Chinese.
See, one of the you are correct. One of the prime reason what our governor is saying is that, कि first the world is in a turmoil. There is downturn in, or you could say recession in Europe, China is slowing down, and you are saying let's manufacture in India mainly for exports. Then why, if there is no demand from the world economy, you are creating the capacity in home, where will those products go? Further, what he is saying is that ki subsidizing this inputs to specific industries, what it will lead to, it will make the domestic competition, matlab it will what you could say make the competition ineffective. Why? Because you are prioritizing, incentivizing certain industries, theek hai. Now if you are incentivizing certain industries, those people who would be getting those incentives, they won't remain competitive in a global environment. भाई यही होता है ना कि आपने किसी इंडस्ट्री को सब्सिडी दे दी, कोई इंडस्ट्री सही नहीं चल रही है, तो क्या होगा, बोलेगा हाँ सही यार, अगर गवर्नमेंट सब्सिडी दे रही है, मेरा काम चल रहा है, व्हाई शुड आई इंप्रूव माई सेल्फ, ठीक है. सो ब्रिंगिंग कॉम्पिटेटिवनेस, ब्रिंगिंग एफिशिएंसी, इट इज़ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट दैट मार्केट शुड बी फ्री, इट शुड बेस्ड ऑन द प्रिंसिपल ऑफ डिमांड एंड सप्लाई, ठीक है. सो दैट इज वॉट रघुराम राजन इज सेइंग कि वी शुड बिल्ड अ स्ट्रॉन्ग सस्टेनेबल इंटीग्रेटेड यूनिफाइड डोमेस्टिक मार्केट. We should focus on those goods for which there is a demand in the domestic economy, and we should incentivize those industries where we need to fulfill the demand for those goods. Rather than building our capacity in such a good which is not in demand in the world economy. So this is very important. This is what Raghuram Rajan is saying, ki rather than make in India, that is you are building unlimited capacity for any particular product, make for India, make for those products for which there is demand in India. Okay. Thereby Mr. Modi is always emphasizing that India has 3 D's, democracy, demand. We have our own economy which can consume a lot. We are importing a lot of products, why not make them in India? So this is the arguments that you could put forward if a question comes in this phase. Other than that, let's talk about the current status, that what is the current status of Make in India. Okay. So here are some facts which you could note it down, because what we believe is that ki there might be a question that do you think that the campaign is working? Do you think that something is happening on the ground? So these are something. FDI inflows have gone up by 48% since the new government came in power. So these are the statistics which I took from the speech of our Prime Minister. He made a speech in the Make in India week, which happened in Mumbai. Okay. So in fact, the inflows in December was one of the highest ever in this country. Further, he said that we want a tax regime which is transparent, stable and predictable. Further, for property and rights, we have a new law for fast tracking arbitration. I think most of you have written an answer for this, paper 2, if you remember. Then there is also a new bill. I think you all know about the dedicated commercial courts and commercial division bench, which we created in the High Court. Further, for an effective IPR policy, we already have a committee. The committee will give its recommendation, and maybe again that will improve the ease of doing business in India. And maybe just adding one point more to this, please go back and write all the indicators and see where India is currently, because many a times it has been asked in the interview, like what is India's position is in HDI index, what is India's position in gender inequality index, what is India's position in ease of doing business, what is India's position in corruption index. Okay. So they are, I think, not more than 10 to 15 indices. Okay. So maybe who all are appearing for the interview, go back, maintain a list. What is the current position? What was the position last year? So moving forward, some more indicators. We jumped 12 ranks in the latest global ranking by the World Bank on ease of doing business. In UNCTAD ranking of investment attractiveness, we jumped or improved from 15th to 9th. World Economic Forum's Global Competitiveness Index, we have jumped by 16 places. Further, Moody, you know, a credit rating agency, it has upgraded our rating as positive. Okay. So my only aim of giving these facts is that whenever a question is asked that what is the current status of the campaign, then you could substantiate your answer, your argument on the basis of these facts, rather than giving a negative answer, no sir, we don't know, yes sir, something is happening, but you know, we are not very sure. So don't give something like a very generalized answer. Be pinpointed, be direct, use the data, because the data, the Prime Minister itself has spoken in his speech, so I think we believe that it is an official data. Further, some more indicators. I think the slides would be available in the website. You could also get the slide from there. I will just highlight the important points. The highest ever production of motor vehicles is recorded in 2015. Electronic manufacturing has grown 6-fold to 18 million. 159 ESDM units were established in India in 2015 only. 2015 highest ever generation of electricity. On the trade front, India's highest ever software exports were recorded in 2015. Also in 2015, our major ports handled the highest ever quantity of cargo. So these are like some facts which says that, okay, the campaign is working. We are able to create a positive environment whereby the global community is looking forward to India. They are looking forward to invest in India. Okay. So these are all the points which says that, okay, the picture is not that gloom. There is something which is happening on the ground. Any other doubts on Make in India campaign or with respect to Make in India? It depends. For example, like if there's a defense contract, so in defense we have sometimes technology transfer component also, that they have to give the technology. For example, like HAL, it is manufacturing an aircraft. So many a times the foreign company, they collaborate, they have a joint venture whereby they produce that particular product and they transfer the technology to India. But still it is not sure, because it is up to the company whether they are collaborating with an Indian group or they are setting their own subsidiary in India. Reverse engineering again is a when we are talking about stringent IP rules, when we are talking about upgrading our IP rules, then reverse engineering is again something which is again taking us back to 1995 something, where we used a lot of reverse engineering and took the lead, especially in pharmaceutical sector. Sorry, I'm not able to.
Made for India.
Huh.
Will this be opposed to trade facilitation of WTO?
Why?
Like free flow from other countries and procuring.
No, but we are not having any duty on imports.
Yeah, and the solar panel case.
Solar panel is a different case. We could take in a different sense because that won't come under this Make in India campaign, because that is something which has to do with dumping duty, countervailing duty. Okay, so that is a totally different case. So moving further, let's talk about the second topic, labor law and labor reforms. Again, this is very important because aap dekhoge to economics mein jyada issues nahi hai. Either they will ask the basics, what is GDP, what do you understand by monetary policy, what do you understand by fiscal policy. Okay, so basics are one line where they could ask some questions. The second line is with respect to the sectors of the economy in which there is some problem or where the government is trying to do something. So labor law is one such sector where the government is trying to do something. Further, it is also an impediment. Until and unless we bring labor reforms, we would not be able to kick start the manufacturing industry. So what are the major labor laws? Can anyone of you tell me?
Industrial Establishment Act.
IDA Act.
Disputes Act.
Contract labor. Regulation and Abolition Act. Any other?
Minimum Wages Act.
Factories Act. Apprenticeship Act 1961. Okay, so these two at least are very important with respect to industrial disputes. What is happening? What are some state governments doing? Contract labor again is very important because it deals with outsourcing of activities. So what are the issues here? First, we need to understand that again, the same thing which we talked about in Make in India campaign, the percentage share in employment in manufacturing is very less. So the missing middle, that is labor rigidity, currently in the investment in manufacturing sector is skewed in favor of capital intensive technology. Ki jitni badi industry set up ho rahi hai, what we are trying to do, we are saying that no, the labor laws are very rigid. We don't want to deal with those labors. So what we are doing, we are bringing more capital in the sense that we are bringing more machines to replace the labor. Okay. So what are the reasons for this? The reasons are strict labor laws, which have led. See, there are two things here you need to understand. Matlab, you could divide the whole sector in like three type of industries. One is like very small, medium, big. So what is happening, these small industries, they are not upgrading themselves to medium. Why? Because once they upgrade, all the labor laws will come into picture. These big industries, they are going for more capital intensive, that is more machines. Why? Because they don't want to deal with a lot of labor issues. Thereby, this segment is remaining. There is nothing here. None of the companies want to be here. Why? There are a lot of labor laws which they have to compile with. So reluctance on part of the small firms to expand, thereby skipping the labor laws regulations and preventing them to take benefit of economies of scale. Further, it discourages investment specifically in labor intensive industries, for example textiles, leather industry. Such industries, again, they want very high flexibility. Flexibility in the sense, for example, textiles. If, for example, this act, like Industrial Dispute Act, if your firm has more than 100 laborers, if you want to retrench, layoffs, then you have to take the permission of the government. Okay, it becomes very difficult for the industry. There is no demand. How much you could produce? Okay. Thereby, what they are doing, they are not making employees permanent. They are saying, okay, let my employee be in contract. On the basis of the contract, I will deal with it. So it discourages investment in labor intensive industries. The fragmented labor market again is one of the important impediment. What do I mean by fragmented labor market? The percentage of union or unionized labor is very less. The percentage of unorganized workers is very high, who are unable to exercise even basic legal rights. They have no social security protection. So this high protection given to organized workers creates again labor rigidities, and most of these unions, where they are mostly in the government sector, in the PSUs. You must have heard about the coal sector. The unions are very strong. You must have heard that whenever we talked about disinvestment in the coal sector, there would always be two or three labor unions who would be saying, no, we won't allow this, we won't allow this. Take care. So there are some segments which are very strong, unionized. There are the other segment which has no basic amenities, no basic rights, even not even job protection. So this is the true picture of the labor market in India. Informalization of labor, I think you all very well know about this point. Nobody wants to have permanent labor. Here, one thing I want to emphasize, specifically with respect to the definition of unorganized sector in India. So this is the official definition which I got from NCUES. So there was a national commission to define the sector. So the unorganized sector consists of all unincorporated private enterprises owned by individuals or households engaged in the sale and production of goods and services operated on a proprietary or partnership basis with less than 10 workers. These 10 workers are very important, because once the worker number of workers are more than 10, your labor laws comes into place. So you know, I think very well this distinction, ki organized, unorganized, okay, formal, informal. Then what are the major issues right now? Take care. You could very well say that neither the quality of employment is good, nor the quantity of employment is good. Female labor force participation rate is very dismal in India. Now, whatever laws we have in India, take care, you very well know that they are not implemented on the ground. Why do you think that there is a new scheme by the government of India, whereby they say that it would be randomized? That is, for inspection, especially labor inspection, there would be like a lucky draw whereby a particular company would be taken and the labor inspector will go. He has to upload the report in a particular time frame. Why? It is just because of this reason that it should not be coercive to the company to reduce the corruption, to reduce Inspector Raj. Problem of unskilled labor force. Why unskilled labor force? One of the main reason is apprenticeship, which is not able to take up in India. Why? Because again, too many government regulations. If you see in Germany, it is very high. I don't recall the exact percentage, but Germany, in Germany, which is known for its manufacturing sector, high skill manufacturing sector, this is very high. That is, people, they undertook skills, they get those skills while working as an apprentice in those companies. After that, they go for a permanent job. Thereby, the government is trying to change this act. I think if you must have heard that, what are the changes that the government brought? It brought changes specifically in this act. Why? So that skills could be provided to the people. Sorry? Yeah. Now, last point here. The major laws, Factories Act 1948, which talks regarding health, safety and welfare of workers, the Industrial Dispute Acts, Contract Labour Regulation and Abolition Act 1979, Apprentice Act 1961. Like, what are the major laws with respect to labour reforms? So if in interview any one of the panel member, they ask you, like, what are the major laws that need reform, especially with respect to labour, okay, you could talk about these acts. Further, in one of the last slides, I will tell you that the government is also planning to segregate or arrange all the labor laws in the country under 5 sections. So we will come on that later. So I will just briefly go through what are the problems with respect to every act. IDA, Industrial Dispute Act 1947. Any company with over 100 workers needs to get permission from the government before retrenching. That is, dispensing with the service of any employee, and you very well know, in a country like India, it is very difficult. Matlab, none of the state government want to give permission to retrench of the workers. Okay? So here what you could say to the panel, okay, sir, we need to change this. Even the Rajasthan government changed this. Rajasthan government, I think make it 300 or 500 workers. 200. I think 300, it's 300. So Rajasthan government said that, okay, it's not 100, it's 300 worker. So if any company which employs more than 300 worker, then they have to get permission from the government.
Sir, when you say retrenching,
I will get to that. There's a technical definition between three. You need to segregate layoff, retrenchment and closure. What is layoff? Layoff is something ki thode din ke liye nikal diya, fir wapas aa gaya. Jab demand kam hai, bol diya ki bhai abhi aaram se baitho. रिट्रेंचमेंट निकाल दिया, कंपनी सप्लाई कम है, सॉरी डिमांड कम है, तो आपने क्या किया, आपने प्रोडक्शन कम कर दिया और वहाँ से रिट्रेंच कर दिया. क्लोजर, बस चलो घर चलते हैं, कंपनी बंद हो गई. Sorry, I have to cross check. But I think even if a single employee, because this is what it says here. So even if a single employee you need to retrench off, then you need to take permission. 15%. I don't know, I have to cross check. So here you could go further and say that what is the suggested reform? For layoffs and retrenchment, the need for government sanction must be increased from firms which employ 100 to 300 workers. Okay, this is one of the reform that you could suggest. Further, you must also have known that when we nikalte hain, to we need to give compensation. Okay, so rather than currently, I think the compensation is only 30 days. You could increase that compensation to 45 days. So that politically bhi sara kuch sound rahe, theek hai. Further, I think there is something which is known as gratuity. Ki jitne saal aapne kaam kiya hai, uske basis pe ek gratuity banti hai, wo aapko dete hain. So you could increase that gratuity on the basis of the amount of work that you have done in the company. Further, I just wanted to say that if you have to bring forward, can we do something good in this front? You could give the example of Rajasthan. What Rajasthan did is that 100 to 300 Further, they said that for recognizing a union, they have to demonstrate a membership of 30%. Further, in Factories Act, the exemption from coverage by labor legislation has been raised from 10 to 20 workers. Further, establishments employing up to 50 contract workers will now be no longer covered under the provisions of Contract Labor Regulation and Abolition Act. We will come to this act in the next slide, that what are the provisions of this act. See, last act talks about, contract labor. Regulation and abolition. What it says is that in certain core sectors, if the employee is a core member, then you can't keep him on contract. You have to keep him as a permanent member. So, see, this is the main provision of this Contract Labor Regulation and Abolition Act. Now, there is a lot of scope of improvement. Why? Because it is not very well defined who is the core worker of an organization. Further, outsourcing, it has been seen, is a global phenomenon. Here, I think there is one other provision is that you can't outsource your work. Okay. So such provisions needs to be changed. Further, there is a limit on the number of employers which could be there on contract. Okay. So what this Rajasthan government did is that they increased that number. I think previously it was 20. They increased that to 50 members.
Changes have been from 10 to 20 workers
in case of units without power.
To be covered under
the Factories Act.
The Factories Act. So, but by doing this, the unorganized sector will further increase from 90.
Nee, again, see, this is one of the points where they are saying that if we have to improve, like what they are saying, let's say more than 10, there are number of regulations in the Factories Act. Okay, the companies are not able to reach economies of scale. Why? Because they have to provide a lot of benefits to the workers. Now what they are saying is that if we do it from 10 to 20, at least the company will think of upscaling its work. The company will think of going ahead. Okay. So like this is one of the main reasons why they are changing it from 10 to 20. Now with respect to those regulation, ki bhai agar 10 worker hain to unme kaun sa regulation lagega, uske liye then the government is bringing other social security schemes, ki Atal Pension Yojana और जो दो तीन स्कीम्स और हैं. सो द गवर्नमेंट इज ब्रिंगिंग दो स्कीम्स सो दैट दे कुड टेक केयर ऑफ देम. सो दिस इज वन ऑफ द आर्ग्यूमेंट दैट लाइक द गवर्नमेंट इज गिविंग. नाउ हाउ टू एड्रेस दिस कंस्ट्रेंट्स, मेनली द कंस्ट्रेंट्स यू कुड सी आर फ्रॉम टू साइड्स, डिमांड एंड सप्लाई. डिमांड कब आएगी? जब ग्रोथ होगी. सो देर शुड बी ग्रोथ इन अवर जीडीपी. सप्लाई के लिए अगेन स्किल, यू नीड टू प्रोवाइड स्किल्स टू देम. जीडीपी ग्रोथ कब होगी? जब आप लेबर लॉ के रेगुलेशंस जो हैं इनको सिंप्लीफाई करोगे, तभी कंपनीज आके इन्वेस्ट करेंगी, तभी आपकी जीडीपी ग्रो करेगी. सो अगेन इट्स ऑल इंटर रिलेटेड. स्पेशल एम्फेसिस ऑन रिलेटिवली मोर लेबर इंटेंसिव सेक्टर्स एंड इंड्यूसिंग अ फास्टर ग्रोथ ऑफ सच सेक्टर. फॉर एग्जाम्पल टेक्सटाइल, लेदर, ठीक है, जहाँ भी आपके लेबर ज़्यादा, फूड प्रोसेसिंग इंडस्ट्री, ठीक है. और सप्लाई साइड, आई थिंक यू ऑल नो, आई डोंट नीड टू रिपीट इट अगेन, कि आप उनको स्किल्स दो, जो लेबर मार्केट है. सो यू मस्ट ऑल्सो हैव हर्ड दैट द गवर्नमेंट इज टॉकिंग अबाउट एम्प्लॉयमेंट एक्सचेंजेस. सो दैट कि एम्प्लॉयमेंट एक्सचेंज में ये होगा कि इधर कंपनीज होंगी, इधर आपके जो वर्कर्स हैं वो होंगे विद देयर ऑल स्किल्स एंड रिज्यूमे, एंड देयर वुड बी गवर्नमेंट एक्सचेंजेस, और ये मिलाने का काम करेंगे. सो दिस इज ऑल्सो आई थिंक अ न्यू स्कीम बाय द गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया. आई डोंट रिमेंबर द नेम एग्जैक्टली. So what are the steps that the government took? I think you need to remember those steps. Shram Suvidha Portal, Random Inspection Scheme, Universal Account Number, Apprentice Protsahan Yojana, Revamped Rashtriya Swasthya Bima Yojana. That is for Social Security. I think they came out with three schemes. Okay, I think I just wrote them down. Social sector schemes, I think we already talked about it. Now, one last point which I wanted to make, which you could tell in the interview to give a perspective that you understand the labor reforms. See, what the government is saying now is that we want to have all those laws under these five heads, that wages, industrial relations, social security benefits, safety and working conditions, and employment training. Now here, one thing you need to understand, which is very important, is that currently what the government is doing is, it's just something which is peripheral. Ki creche dal diya mothers ke liye, ki toilet bana diya, kuch kar diya, safety regulations bada di, thode bahut provisions kar diye. What the government is not doing yet, and because it requires a lot of this political will, is can it change the power relation between the worker and the employer? Are you getting my point? Okay. Can it change something with respect to industrial relations? Because again, that requires kuch bhi aap unions ke respect mein karoge. There is a lot of setback from the side of the union. Kuch bhi aap like retrenchment ke respect mein karoge, again there would be a lot of pressure from the side of the people who are working. So can you do anything to solve the power asymmetry between the management and the worker? Which comes under, first is wages, second is industrial relations. So until and unless we do something in these two aspects, there will not be any real reform. You are just tweaking on the fringes. Aap bol rahe ho ki theek hai, apprentice 20 le rahe ho, ab 40 le lo. 50% sarkar paise de degi, 50% aap paise de do. ठीक है, तो यू आर जस्ट डूइंग नथिंग, यू आर जस्ट लाइक प्लेइंग हेयर देयर एक्सेट्रा एक्सेट्रा. ठीक है, सो अंटिल एंड अनलेस समथिंग सब्सटैंशियल इज डन विथ रिस्पेक्ट टू इंडस्ट्रियल रिलेशन, विथ रिस्पेक्ट टू वेजेस, यू वोंट से दैट लेबर रिफॉर्म इन इंडिया इज लाइक इज बीइंग डन इन अ वेरी सीरियस मैनर. सो इट इज फॉर द गवर्नमेंट टू सी दैट कैन इट कम आउट समथिंग विद दिस. सो लेट्स होप सो, इफ बिकॉज इफ दे नॉट, देन अगेन it is very difficult for Make in India campaign to come forward, because again companies won't be able to set up their manufacturing unit if they don't find the labor regulations which is in comparison with that of other countries, because there are a lot of other countries who are again competing for getting that FDI. Okay, labor is a very important factor. Why? Because you all know what are the factors of production: land, labor, capital. So labor is an important component of production. Until and unless you provide them skill, you simplify the labor laws, it is very difficult for the manufacturing sector again to kick off. Thereby, I think there was a question in paper 3 mains also, if you remember, on labor law, labor reform. So such is the importance of this sector. Moving ahead, see, the power asymmetry is that na ki the manager has got a lot of power. Companies in which there is a union, they have got power, but most companies in India, they don't have a union. So they are at the mercy of the manager. If labor laws have been if the implementation of labor laws has been strict on the ground, then there is no need to worry. Okay, what are the labor laws we have, they will take care of them. But what is happening right now? Right now the implementation is tardy. It is neither benefiting the workers nor it is benefiting the management. Okay, so until and unless like they have a truce, they will say for this contract regulation act, what should be the number? Currently it's 100, let's say it's 300. Again, they have to decide this power, which side it will go. Forming a union, 10% of the members can form a union, or 20% of members can form a union, 30% of them can form a union. Outsourcing, contracts, okay. So all these issues, they are between what? They are between the workers and the management. Okay. So again, the government has to see that up till what pace it can go. Can it give some powers to the from the workers or unions to the manager? For example, closure. Can they go for a closure without the intervention of the government? Can they work on market lines that if there is not demand, if there is no demand from the world economy? For example, textile sector. The world economy is going down. Textile is one of those sectors which we export. ठीक है? What will happen to those companies? भाई manager को तो salary देनी पड़ेगी. There is no demand. वो उसकी capacity utilize नहीं होगी. So he has to retrench off. Maybe he could go for a closure. So until and unless he can go for a closure, how will he again start a new company? Or let's say कि again when the economic cycle will come back, when there is demand, how will he go further? अगर उसी समय उसने अपने सारे assets खत्म कर दिए तो. So this is what I was talking about, this power asymmetry. Can the government bring some laws, okay, through which they could help the manager to better control the industry or its unit according to the demand of according to the forces of demand and supply?
Sir, as you mentioned that unions are strong in PSUs and whereas unions are not strong others, what is the basic cause there?
See, one of the basic causes is with respect to this key. A formal sector in India is very small. In that formal sector also, nearly 80% of that sector is government sector. Thereby, that is the reason that unions are strong. This is like the prime reason, because if you again see the sectors, manufacturing sector, mainly government activities undertaken. Service sector, which is a strong component of growth, there what is the need for a union? नहीं, अगेन माय पॉइंट इज दैट ना कि यू हैव टू रिकनसाइल द इंटरेस्ट ऑफ द वर्कर विद दैट ऑफ द कंपनी. इफ देयर इज नो डिमांड, हाउ विल द कंपनी सर्वाइव? दैट इज व्हाट द कंपनी सेज कि भाई डिमांड नहीं है तो व्हाट विल वी डू विद द कैपेसिटी दैट वी हैव जनरेटेड? वी हैव टू रिट्रेंच ऑफ. दैट इज व्हाट हैपेंस इन अ रिसेशन. लेट्स से यूएस रिसेशन 2008, अ लॉट ऑफ कंपनीज लेड ऑफ अ लॉट ऑफ वर्कर्स. व्हाई? बिकॉज देयर वाज नो डिमांड. सो एटलीस्ट इफ दे डू लाइक दिस, द कंपनी विल सर्वाइव. Let's say they are working with 100 people, they are now working with 50 people, catering to the demand. Once the economic cycles come back, they will let all 50 people come again, 100 people. Now what will happen to those 50 people? This is for those 50 and the government to decide. Maybe the government can give you an unemployment assurance. What happens in the advanced economies? Okay. So this is what when you are moving from a socialist kind of era to a capitalist era in a very broad generalized way, this is what happens. So
do we have any technical difference between unorganized and informal
sector? See, when according to the report which came in 2005, they say it is used interchangeably. Formal, informal, it is mainly used with respect to advanced economies. Take care. It is the concept, it's not very widely understood even in India. So that particular commission, it says it's used interchangeably. One of the major issues, I think, which is of prime concern this year is NPA. So what is NPA? Is non-performing asset. So why an asset? हाँ, इट स्टिल हैज वैल्यू, इट स्टिल कैन बी रिट्रीव. ठीक है, ऐसा नहीं है कि भाई डूब गए बचे हैं, बट ये है कि इट्स लाइक अ प्रोविजनिंग नॉर्म कि 90 डेज द कंपनी इज नॉट एबल टू रिपे, देन यू हैव अ प्रोविजन दैट दैट पर्टिकुलर लोन वुड बी कैटेगराइज्ड एज NPA. सो आई थिंक दिस इज वन ऑफ द क्वेश्चंस पीपल हु आर अपीयरिंग फॉर द इंटरव्यू, दे नीड टू बी वेरी विजिलेंट for such kind of questions, because you every time say a non-performing asset, non-performing asset, they could very well ask, no, why an asset? So what are non-performing assets? Loans made by the bank or finance company on which repayment or interest payments are not being made on time. Once the borrower has failed to make interest or principal payments for 90 days, it is considered NPA. Current figures, 2015 amount of NPAs was at 4.62% of the total advances by the banks. And the ratio of restructured standard assets to gross advances grew to 6.44%. Thereby, the total stressed assets is 11.6% of the gross advances. अब देखो ये figure change होते रहते हैं. This is what I got from the last report. अगर आप I think जो आपके पास NPA वाला issue है, I think उसमें भी यही है. Yeah. Now see what happens is that ki like the advances that bank give, they are categorized into two. Standard, non-standard. जो सही से चल रहा है debt pay कर रहा है they are standard. 90 days debt pay नहीं हुआ generally they are known as non-standard assets. उसके बाद भी अगर 90 to 365 days doubtful assets, there is various level of provisioning. Provisioning आप लोग समझते हैं कि मान लीजिए अगर बैंक ने एक रुपए दिया तो बेस्ड ऑन द प्रोबेबिलिटी दैट क्या वो एक रुपए वापस आएगा नहीं आएगा, दे हैव टू प्रोविजन समथिंग. फॉर एग्जाम्पल फॉर अ स्टैंडर्ड एसेट्स दे प्रोविजन 0.4%. For this NPA 90 to 365, I think the provisioning is 20%. I am not very sure is 10 or 20. I think it's 20. I think it's 10%. From 365 to the next year, it's 20%, and second to third year, it's 30%. After 30%, the provisioning is termed as after this 3 year bad loan. You must also have heard a term which is in the recent news, write off kar diya apni balance sheet se. Theek hai, so this generally happens after this 3rd year. Now one thing we have to understand is why NPAs, like what is happening. The government is saying that we are growing at a very high pace.
So you said about provisioning, this 0.4% of that amount is kept with the banks or any?
The bank keeps with itself on the
so
basis
it
of
cannot be lent out.
It cannot be lent, matlab it keeps us safe with respect to the amount that it advances. So now we have to understand that why NPAs are rising. So there is a debate, we will come to that. What are the major sectors? I think if you know the sector, then you would very well be able to come out with an explanation that why there are rising NPAs. Mining sector, iron and steel sector, infrastructure sector, aviation too, I think you all very well know, the king of good times, textile. So majorly it has to do with respect to the slowdown in the world economy, with respect to commodity prices which have become so low, with respect to the policies of the government. Mining, you know what happened with respect to coal allocation. Infrastructure, you know what happened, there are a lot of bottlenecks. Pehle bhai banks advance le liya, pata chala ki aapko land ka acquisition nahi ho paya. And the company is not able to repay, because when you will go back and see the private companies, a lot of private companies are infrastructure companies who have not been able to pay their loans. A lot of them are power companies. A lot of people, they went for a power plant, for example a gas based power plant. Ab hua kya, KGDC se gas nahi aa rahi hai, kaise chalaoge? So the companies are not able to repay. पे बैक नहीं हुआ, एनपीए बन गया. सो दिस इज वन ऑफ द रीजन, इंपॉर्टेंट रीजन लाइक कि व्हाट हैपेंड अमंग बैंक्स. अगेन यू हैव टू अंडरस्टैंड दिस पॉइंट, पब्लिक सेक्टर बैंक्स आर द वर्स्ट अफेक्टेड विथ 14.1% ऑफ द एसेट्स बीइंग स्ट्रेस्ड, फॉलोड बाई प्राइवेट बैंक्स एट 4.6% एंड फॉरन बैंक्स एट 3.4%. हेयर वन थिंग यू नो, वेन एवर यू रीड सच काइंड ऑफ अ स्टेटमेंट, वन थिंग ऑलवेज लाइक कम्स इन माइंड कि इज दिस पॉलिटिकल, इज दिस समथिंग विच हैज़ टू डू विद द पॉलिटिकल एग्जीक्यूटिव. Why? Because there is a department of banking in the finance ministry, because most of the banks are public sector banks which are controlled by the government. So are there signs of crony capitalism too?
Yes.
Okay, so this is one point where you could say ki yes sir, there are signs of crony capitalism, but there are also private banks and foreign banks where NPA is high. So sir, it is not only because of crony capitalism, there are other reasons too. There is economic slowdown, there is excess capacity which was generated in 2009-10, there was government policy with respect to infrastructure where like in 2012 and 13 a lot of infrastructure firms have bidded very strongly in public private partnership. Aap logon ne suna hoga na ki national highway ka contract itna upar gaya, theek hai. So that is what led to rise in this NPAs. One other factor which a lot of scholars are saying is because of the Reserve Bank of India, the Reserve Bank's policy ki you can't evergreen, because most of the time what happens na ki aap NPA ko restructure kar dete ho and then you don't see ki okay it's an NPA, theek hai, that is book management what you tend to say. But now the Reserve Bank has become very strict in the last 2 years. Thereby, the banks are increasingly coming and saying, no, this is an NPA, this is an NPA. So this is also, scholars are saying, one of the reasons. Further, you have to understand about willful defaulter. Ki willful defaulter kaun hai? The share of willful defaulters in gross NPA has been 21% as of September 2015. So I will come to the next point. Who are these willful defaulters? So one prime example, I think you all know very well. The RBI has said, these are the four guidelines under which you could say that one is a willful defaulter. Matlab agar aapne bank se paisa x kaam ke liye liya aur usko y mein laga diya, then you are a willful defaulter. Matlab kisi kaam ke liye paisa le rahe ho, kahin aur laga rahe ho aur apna debt repay nahi kar rahe ho, theek hai. To that is where it says, if there's a default in repayment obligations by the unit to the lender even when it has the capacity to honor the said obligation, the funds are not utilized for the specific purpose for which finance was there, when the funds have been siphoned off and not been utilized for the purpose for which it was availed, theek hai. This is very important. That is why I will come in the next slide ki why we need to declare people as willful defaulter, theek hai. Because most of the times it happens na ki banks to bahut sare hain, ek se paise le lo, theek hai, loan nahi ho raha, dusre se paise le lo, theek hai. But once someone is declared as willful defaulter, there are certain provisions. There are certain provisions like there is a institution, CIBIL, Credit Information Bureau Limited. ठीक है, the information would be sent to CIBIL. ठीक है, जहाँ पर यह बता दिया जाएगा कि भाई ये willful defaulter है. Thereby, whenever he approaches any other bank for a loan or for any other activity, the bank should have a prior information ki he has defaulted on his loan on that bank. Okay, so we should be like before giving the loan we should think whether we should give him since he is already a defaulter. Theek hai. Then the further what they could do, they could choke off most credit channels since no additional lending facility is available for the bank. What they could do other than this is that ki agar uske paas do account hai, dusre account mein paise pade hain, they could initiate a legal legal suit or legal process against him and ask him to pay from the other account to this account. Theek hai. So like thereby the RBI is saying increasingly ki please find those willful defaulters and tell that you are one. Okay, so that their name goes to the central information, like the central repository, every other bank know that he is one of them. Or kahin se bhi provisioning ho sakti hai, kahin se bhi chances hain ki hum usse paise nikal sakte hain, to wo paise hame mil jaye on the basis of the legal provisions. further he is not permitted to float. It's okay. I think Make in India is going very well. So further, a willful defaulter is not permitted to float any new business for a period of 5 years from the date of being declared a willful defaulter. तभी आपको पता है कि भाई साहब यूके चले गए, अब इंडिया में तो कुछ हो नहीं पाएगा. Now what are the reasons for NPA? Please note down. Please be direct. Borrower side, economy slowdown हो रही है, willful default हो रहे हैं, global economy slowdown कर रही है. बैंक के साइड से क्या हो रहा है, बैड लैंडिंग प्रैक्टिसेस. किसी का दूर का कोई रिश्तेदार था, वो पॉलिटिशियन था, उसने उसका कहीं पे कराया था और इसने इसका करा दिया. And that happens a lot. I think many of you who have worked in banks, this is a practical issue. Inadequate capacity to evaluate projects. I think last day, I was listening to a debate on NPAs. What one of the prior chairman of a prominent bank was saying is that there is a culture. The point that he was trying to make is that ki most of the policy of the government, theek hai, with respect to finance are implemented by the banks. So a bank like has kind of two policies. कि एक आपका सोशल सेक्टर का होता है, एक आपका कमर्शियल होता है. सो एवरीवन वेरी वेल नोज दैट दिस इज वेरी डिफिकल्ट टू कम बैक व्हाटएवर द गवर्नमेंट इज लेंडिंग टू द सोशल सेक्टर. फॉर एग्जांपल द पीएसआर गाइडलाइंस, जो भी आपकी प्रायोरिटी सेक्टर लेंडिंग गाइडलाइंस है, ठीक है, दे नो दैट इट इज वेरी डिफिकल्ट टू कम बैक. ठीक है, देयर बाय अ कल्चर डेवलप्स इन बैंक्स टू बी लाइक हाँ आराम से करते हैं यार, चले ज्यादा फाइट नहीं है. सो ही वाज सेइंग दैट the same culture goes on to this commercial sector too, rather than bank being managed in a very professional way. Theek hai, so this is happening. Theek hai, so now what is the reform? So in that debate, what he was saying is that ki let bank be managed in a very professional way. If the government has to come out with any policy, theek hai, make a budgetary provision for that, rather than making it for the banks to do that particular work. फॉर एग्जाम्पल आप लोगों ने सुना होगा, लेट्स से कि इंटरेस्ट सबवेंशन स्कीम जो फार्मर्स को दी जाती है, कि अगर वो एक बार लोन पे करते हैं तो 3% लोन कम करते हैं, 7% पे मिलता है, बाद में 4% पे देते हैं. ठीक है, तो वाई नॉट हैविंग अ बजटरी प्रोविजन रदर दैन हैविंग इट थ्रू द चैनल ऑफ द बैंक्स. जनधन स्कीम, यू हैव टू ओपन अ लॉट ऑफ न्यू अकाउंट्स, यू जस्ट हैव टू ओपन अकाउंट्स, यू हैव टू डू इट, दैट्स अ गवर्नमेंट पॉइंट, बट यू नो दैट दोज अकाउंट्स दैट आर दे आर नॉट यील्डिंग. There is no transaction. All the cost has to be borne by the banks. ठीक है, so it perpetuates a culture in banks. ठीक है, and that same culture comes into this commercial arm also. I'm not saying this is the only point, but this is one of the point which a guy who was in a prominent position in a bank was arguing. Other than that, inadequate capacity to evaluate projects, political interference, ineffective recovery tribunal. We will come, just 1 minute, we will come back to the point of bankruptcy law and bankruptcy code in the next topic. Yeah, sure.
Sir, can we say something, like, because this Jan Dhan Yojana has that overdraft facility, this is also
late. Overdraft, it's still not not implemented.
It has been implemented in my native state.
Okay. Against, see, मतलब I don't think that would be very valid in the sense that when you talk about the objectives of Jan Dhan, that is to provide unconditional credit. Because let's say if you go to a bank, you ask for a credit, they won't give it to you until and unless you have a credit history or you give a collateral. But when we are talking about the Jan Dhan account, we are giving unconditional credit. They don't have to provide any collateral. So obviously the percentage risk, the banks also knows the percentage risk is very high. The government has already created a fund for those NPAs. I think credit risk guarantee, I think there is some fund.
Is
the government has already created.
Fund 5% for all this overdraft facility bad.
So what is the full name of the fund? Credit?
Credit guarantee.
Credit guarantee fund. So that is for such cases only. Any other question? Yeah.
So is it apt to say about the domestic economy slowdown? See, we have been going on an unbridled path of more than 7% growth. Despite the global economy slowdown, so how far is it correct to say about
See, growth is one point, but you also have to say which sectors are growing. So NPAs are rising on those sectors where there is a slump throughout the world economy. For example, steel sector, commodity prices, they are low throughout the world economy. Okay? So those are some of the sectors which are a major concern for rising NPAs. So you could say, sir, that despite growth in GDP, we are witnessing slump in certain sectors. They are infrastructure, mainly with respect to infrastructural bottlenecks, for example, road sector, power sector, in which the percentage of NPA is very high. So impact, ab dekhiye impact kya hoga, bhai banks, money is the only asset. They give loans and they get interest out of it. That is how they manage. So one of the main aim or purpose of bank is efficient allocation of resources. So what NPAs are doing, they are not helping banks in the efficient allocation of resources. So obviously, this is something very obvious. Ki what will happen to bank? Bhai, aapne loan liya, aapne loan pay nahi kiya. To bank ko profit nahi hoga. Interest payment to chhodo, jo principal diya tha, wo bhi chala gaya. और पैसा किसका लगा? वी द पीपल. सो शेयर होल्डर्स आर एडवर्सली अफेक्टेड. फर्दर, इफ योर एनपीए इज वेरी हाई, यू आर अ पब्लिक लिस्टेड कंपनी, द प्राइजेस ऑफ योर शेयर विल ऑल्सो इरोड, योर मार्केट लाइक मार्केट रेटिंग्स विल ऑल्सो इरोड. ठीक है, देयर बाय आई थिंक द आरबीआई गवर्नर हैज सेड दैट बाई 2017 वी मस्ट मेक द एनपीएस clear for most of the banks. Okay, we have to do something. I will come to the steps that what could be done. Further, one other important point is that if you have huge NPAs, then you must also understand that it is a huge capital which is stuck up. By one of the important component of a bank is to rotate the money. Isse liya, isko de diya, usse liya, usko de diya. Ye kya ho raha hai ki itna bada capital is just stuck up lying there of no use. ठीक है, सो दिस अगेन हैज ह्यूज रिपरकशंस फॉर द इंडियन इकोनॉमी. व्हाई? इतना कैपिटल यहीं पे स्टक हो गया. नाउ इफ यू गो एंड आस्क बैंक फॉर अ लोन, बैंक बोलेगा यार मैक्सिमम कैपिटल तो यहाँ लग गया, आपको मैं लोन कहाँ से दूँ? ठीक है, सो बैंक विल हेजिटेट इन गिविंग लोन टू एनी अदर गाय अंटिल अनलेस इट हैज इट्स कैपिटल अवेलेबल. सो यू नीड टू डू समथिंग. देयरबाय इफ यू हैव हर्ड मेनी इकोनॉमिस्ट, दे आर टॉकिंग अबाउट बैंकरप्सी कोड. Something needs to be done. What could be done? Some of the steps which you could say in the interview, that before giving the loans, credit information of the borrower needs to be seen. Defaulters needs to be seen, that who has defaulted on their loan, what could be done to them. Further, what the RBI is doing, RBI is saying that try to find early. There are signals on the basis of which you could early find out an NPA. For example, 30 din ke baad paisa dena tha, pata chala ki 50 din ke baad paise de raha hai. Make a category, assess the risk and provision accordingly. Theek hai, this is what RBI is trying to argue. Early identification of problem cases, timely restructuring of accounts which are considered to be viable, taking prompt steps by bank for recovery or sale of unviable accounts. I will just come to this point, that what could be done once there is an NPA. Then selling the NPAs to securitization companies, reconstruction companies. Okay, so let me come to the last point. Now let's say there is an NPA. So there is an NPA. Now what are the available options with the bank? Can anyone of you tell me? SARFAESI Act is one. Okay. What else? Asset reconstruction company. Anything else? Provisioning comes under this only.
Restructuring.
Restructuring of loans. Sorry?
Debt recovery tribunals.
Who?
Guarantors rather than sir. I mean, we can catch them also.
Ninish. How many of you we will catch? So, one last is strategic debt priest. So, this is the latest scheme by the RBI, strategic debt restructuring. Now, see what could be done. भाई आपके पास एक NPA आ गया, ठीक है, NPA मतलब he is not able to pay interest, ठीक है. So what normally companies do is either what they will say ki okay I will restructure your loan. What do you mean by restructuring your loan? They will say ki आपका इतना interest payment था, इतना principal है, let's make them again as a new principal, और इस पे हम let's say पहले x percent interest था, अब हम x minus 1% interest ले लेंगे आपसे, ठीक है. सो दिस इज वन वे कि आपने लोन को रिस्ट्रक्चर कर दिया, ठीक है. वंस यू डू दिस द एसेट इज नो मोर एन NPA, इट विल कम अंडर द कैटेगरी ऑफ स्ट्रेस्ड एसेट्स, ठीक है. दिस इज वन वे. सेकेंड वे, करेंटली व्हाट द RBI इज सेइंग इज दैट स्ट्रैटेजिक डेप्थ रिस्ट्रक्चरिंग. व्हाट हियर द RBI इज सेइंग इज दैट कि एक मिनट, एक चीज और बताता हूँ कि व्हाट एल्स कुड बी डन. What else could be done is that the bank could take over the company, instill some professionals who can run the company, theek hai, and make him or make the company pay, theek hai. So that is one of the way to take forward, because whatever the assets that has been created out of this capital, they are lying there, theek hai. It might be mismanagement of the promoters of the company, because of which the company is not able to pay. Or it might be that because those assets, they are of no use now. So it is for the banks currently to decide that whether they want to take over the company, and they want to see that whether we could revive the company, or whatever assets that they have, can we sell them and get back at least something. Ki bhai Kingfisher to mila nahi, plane leke hi bhej dete hain, but baad mein pata chala plane bhi leased pe the, wahan se bhi kuch nahi mila. सो करेंटली RBI इज सेइंग कि स्ट्रैटेजिक डेप्थ रिस्ट्रक्चरिंग करते हैं. इसमें हम क्या करेंगे कि जितनी जितना लोन है उतने की इक्विटी बना के वी विल हैव 51% इक्विटी कंट्रोल इन द कंपनी दैट फेल्स टू रीपे इवन आफ्टर इट्स डेप्थ्स आर रिजेक्ट टू गिव द मैनेजमेंट अ सेकेंड चांस. पहले तो आपने रिस्ट्रक्चर कर दिया, जिसको बोलते हैं कॉर्पोरेट डेप्थ रिस्ट्रक्चरिंग सिस्टम है. अगर उससे भी बात नहीं बनी तो क्या किया आपने, अपना प्रिंसिपल और इंटरेस्ट को मिला के कंपनी में 51% स्टेक ले लिया, ठीक है. 51% स्टेक लेके आपने बोला कि चलो अब देखते हैं हम क्या कर सकते हैं, कैन वी इंस्टिल सम प्रोफेशनल्स हु कुड रन द कंपनी, और कैन वी गेट अ बायर फ्रॉम आउटसाइड हु वॉन्ट्स टू टेक दैट कंपनी. क्योंकि रिस्ट्रक्चर करने के बाद कंपनी की एक वैल्यूएशन होगी, ठीक है. इज देयर एनी अदर कंपनी हु वॉन्ट्स टू बाय दिस कंपनी ऑन दैट वैल्यूएशन, और इज देयर सम प्रोफेशनल्स विच वी कुड कीप टू रन दिस कंपनी, ठीक है. हियर RBI सेइंग दैट द रिलैक्सेशंस एक्सेट्रा एक्सेट्रा आर प्रोवाइडेड ओनली फॉर 18 मंथ्स. लोन्स विच आर रिस्ट्रक्चर्ड अंडर द स्कीम दे वुड नॉट बी ट्रीटेड एज एन NPA. If banks are unable to sell to a new promoter within 18 months, then all regulatory relaxation cease to exist and lender have to treat these assets as NPA and make 100% provisioning against those assets in majority of the cases. Okay. So now currently I think we have seen a lot of companies, if you go to Indian Express, there is a very good article, strategic debt restructuring explained. एक आपने देखा होगा इंडियन एक्सप्रेस में एक्सप्लेन का कॉलम आता है, ठीक है. सो यू मे गो एंड रीड अबाउट इन डिटेल अबाउट दिस. आई डिडंट इंक्लूड बिकॉज इट विल बिकम टू टेक्निकल देन. देयर फैक्ट्स एक्सेट्रा एक्सेट्रा आर गिवन. हाँ, मतलब कॉर्पोरेट डेप्थ रिस्ट्रक्चरिंग में ना मैनेजमेंट रिमेन्स द सेम, प्रोमोटर्स आर द सेम, एवरीथिंग इज द सेम. वी जस्ट गेव देम अनदर चांस to like mend everything and repay the debt, but after that also they are not able to, then we will take a stake in the company and then the bank will decide what to do. bank may instill a new management, bank may have a valuation and ask any other company if they want to take this company. No, it's not about reducing the interest rate. I just gave one example that this could be happening.
This is about the corporate debt. What about the agriculture debt? It doesn't come under the past year construction or
debt. Yeah, agricultural debt kya hai to aisa hai ki most of the times government waiver de deti hai, because if you remember about the P. Chidambaram's budget, 60,000 crore waiver to the agricultural crop loans. Yeah, see, NPA in agricultural sector, na, they are first of all very small in number. Most of the time, NABARD takes care of them. Ki NABARD mein provisioning ke features hote hain, aur wo matlab like settle kar deti hai.
Sir, a critique of this is also provided in a way that this does not happen with the common people. This is, there's a nexus going on. Like,
see, again, we have to think from an interview perspective. You are an administrator. We can only talk with respect to things which are there in the government records, which are there in the statistics. We can't tell in the interview, sir, aapko to pata hi hai ki politicians aise hote hain, log aise hote hain, wo aisa karte hain. You just can't say na. So I think it's better that we take the government official perspective. We say ki sir, this is the problem, and then provide a solution. Sir, this could be a possible solution. So RBI is doing very good. The government is also. The government has also acknowledged the situation, and they are bringing steps which could be taken to tackle the above situation. Rather than going on to ki sir, ye to crony capitalism hai sir, wo Adani usse mila hua hai, aapko pata hi hai to.
So it's a conceptual note. Sir, stressed assets apart from the restructured loans, what all do they include?
NPA plus restructured loans. See, write-off, again, it's a technical term that we need to understand. Write-off doesn't mean ki doob gaya. Theek hai? Write-off just means that we are taking that asset from our balance sheet. Still, the company has to repay the loan. Still, the bank will take all the recourse that the bank has.
But there is a substantial loss that is going on to
the bank. There is. That is why there is this debate now. Ki, there is a substantial write-off which is going on. One of the arguments that again is said is that ki, once you take that amount from your balance sheet, you don't have any incentive to get back that loan. That is again said forward. But then companies tend to say that no, we have to maintain our balance sheet. We have to, from taxation purpose also. Yeah, dekho, again, that is a political question. That is, I don't think, very well argued from an administrative point of view. That is a political question. It is wrong for the company to bid aggressively. You could also say that market forces are one of the reason for that. Because when the company gave a bid for them, then the economy was at a very high pace. After that, there were a number of policy blocks. Most of the infrastructure for which they have bidded, they were not able to take off. ठीक है, तो यू कांट डायरेक्टली ब्लेम द पॉलिटिकल क्लास फॉर दैट. इकोनॉमी फोर्सेस ऑफ डिमांड एंड सप्लाई आर ऑल्सो एट प्ले. सो इट इज लाइक ऑल दिस फैक्टर्स विच हैज लेड टू दिस राइज इन एनपीएस.
अपार्ट फ्रॉम हैविंग अ क्लीन इमेज इन टर्म्स ऑफ लेंडिंग कैपेसिटी, व्हाट अदर पर्पस कुड अ राइट ऑफ सर्व?
That is a technical term. That is why most of the people say. मतलब it's not a write off कि आपको वो खत्म ही कर दिया. It's just that कि आपने अपनी balance sheet clear करनी है, इसलिए आपने उसको अपने balance sheet से clear कर दिया. Even the RBI, sorry, even the SBI said that कि what we do is that ना कि हम write off ना सिर्फ जो branch मतलब जो head office है ना वहाँ से करते हैं. In the balance sheet of the branch it still remains. तो this is one of the explanation which was given by SBI to Indian Express. Because if you go back and see Indian Express, they carried on a story on this write-offs, I think 4 to 5 days back. Yes. So on that story, all the three replied, RBI replied, State Bank of India replied, and the Finance Ministry replied. So maybe go back and read that. I think that could help you in understanding the concept. Moving forward, aur kya kar sakte hain hum?
So regarding SDR, just suppose that the borrower
borrowed from three lenders, 5 each. So 15 is the total amount which he borrowed. Now through this SDR, how are we going to do it 51%
here? मतलब simple ना, 115 हो गया ना, इसका 51% हो जाएगा. जितना आपने प्रिंसिपल अमाउंट लिया प्लस जितना इंटरेस्ट बकाया है उसको आप ऐड कर लो, उसके बेसिस पे कंपनी की वैल्यूएशन होगी, उसके बेसिस पे जो 51% स्टेक है दैट विल बी टेकन बाय द
दैट वुड बी वे वे हाई, आई मीन टू मच पे अहेड लाइक व्हाट दे लेंडेड. सो उन्होंने दे लेंडेड ओनली 50 रुपीस एंड नाउ दे आर क्लेमिंग फॉर 50.
नहीं, अगेन आउट ऑफ दोस टोटल अमाउंट देयर वुड बी मार्केट वैल्यूएशन अगेन. ठीक है, मार्केट वैल्यूएशन के अकॉर्डिंग जितना इसका पैसा है, ठीक है, वो उतने स्टेक ले लेंगे. So what more needs to be done? Judicial delays. मतलब I think this all you know well. I'm skipping this part. Finance Standing Committee ने क्या कहा? Same thing which we discussed since this long. It has reiterated the same thing कि forensic audit होना चाहिए. जो willful defaulter है, shame, name and shame जो हम बोलते हैं कि name and shame करो उनको, और social pressure could also act like nothing much. Let's come to the next topic then. I think now with respect to NPA, you are in a position to I feel that give an answer. Moving to the last and the most important again topic, bankruptcy. So why reform bankruptcy process? What is the draft bankruptcy code? Is there we have an international comparison? What is there in US or Germany or UK, and what is its impact? Again, it is very well related to the NPAs only. Ki what will happen, like if a company wants to go for closure, okay, if a company wants to exit, are there process available in India for which they can exit? Because most of the times you must have heard that na, ki the legal process is such that the case goes on for like 7 to 8 years. इन दैट टाइम उसके और जितने एसेट्स हैं वो सब बेच के अपना चला जाता है. ठीक है, सो कैन वी हैव सम प्रोसेस थ्रू विच वी कुड रिफॉर्म दिस प्रोसेस एंड वी कुड मूव फॉरवर्ड. सो देयर बाय एवरी इकोनॉमिस्ट दे आर सेइंग दैट वी मस्ट हैव अ बैंकरप्सी लॉ, वी मस्ट हैव अ बैंकरप्सी कोड. सो बैंकरप्सी इज अ लीगल स्टेटस यूजुअली इम्पोज्ड बाय अ कोर्ट ऑन अ फर्म और इंडिविजुअल अनेबल टू मीट दैट ऑब्लिगेशन. ठीक है, व्हाट वी आर ट्राइंग टू डू, वी आर ट्राइंग टू क्रिएट अ फॉर्मल इनसॉल्वेंसी रेजोल्यूशन प्रोसेस फॉर बिजनेसेस आइदर बाय कमिंग अप विद अ सर्वाइवल मैकेनिज्म और बाय इंश्योरिंग देयर स्पीडी लिक्विडेशन. ठीक है, सिंपल जो भी हमने बात किया अभी यहाँ एनपीए में, व्हाट कुड हैव बीन डन, व्हाट वी आर ट्राइंग टू क्रिएट अ लीगल मैकेनिज्म फॉर दैट. ठीक है, कि आउट ऑफ दैट स्पीडी रेजोल्यूशन कि एक साल में ही बैंक्स को इतनी पावर्स मिल जाए दैट if there is an asset which is lying unutilized, theek hai, then the bank could dispose of that asset and get at least some amount back. Why a bankruptcy code is required? Because one point which we talked about before is that there is a huge amount of capital which is lying. So there is huge amount of assets which are also created. For example, let's say under PPP there is a road which needs to be built. ठीक है, but what happened midway the promoter भाग गया. भाई 10 किलोमीटर की रोड थी, 8 किलोमीटर बनाया, it was on PPP 10 ईयर के बेसिस पे, and he said कि no I won't be able to. ठीक है, then what could be done? So here what they are saying is that कि we need to find कि either is there any alternative mechanism which is available. Can we find a different promoter which could complete that 2 kilometers and then can take a toll? जो आप टोल टैक्स टोल देते हो ना, हमेशा रोड पर जाते हो, कैन टेक अ टोल एंड कैन पे द बैंक बैक. ठीक है, सो दिस इज वॉट दे आर टॉकिंग ऑफ. इन अ कंट्री लाइक इंडिया पर्टिकुलरली बिकॉज ऑफ डिलेज इन मेकिंग डिसीजन ऑन द वायबिलिटी ऑफ द बिजनेस दैट इज इट टेक्स अ लॉट ऑफ टाइम फॉर द बैंक्स टू फाइंड वेदर अ बिजनेस इज वायबल और नॉट. जो भी लोन पर डिफॉल्ट करता है, फर्स्ट यू नीड टू असेस इस करेंट वैल्यूएशन, यू नीड टू फाइंड कि क्या ये कंपनी चलेगी या नहीं चलेगी. टैक्टिक्स एम्प्लॉयड बाय द कंपनी प्रोमोटर्स टू डिले रीऑर्गेनाइजेशन और अटेम्प्ट्स टू सेल ऑफ एसेट्स, आई थिंक दिस यू ऑल नो वेरी वेल कि अ लॉट ऑफ कंपनीज दे यूज अ लॉट ऑफ टैक्टिक्स कि किंगफिशर को जब बोला कि आपको विलफुल डिफॉल्टर बनाएंगे हम, इट वेंट टू द कोर्ट. दे नो इट इज गोन हैपन, बट गोइंग टू द कोर्ट इट गिव्स देम अ लिवरेज ऑफ लाइक 1 year or 2 years व्हेन द केसेस आर पेंडिंग इन द कोर्ट. ठीक है, चेंजेस ऑफ मैनेजमेंट, लिटिगेशन दैट गोज ऑन एंड ड्रैग ऑन द बिजनेस यूनिट्स, इवेंचुअली व्हाट हैपेंस इज दैट ना कि 7-8 साल निकल जाते हैं, देन नोबडी केयर्स. And what happened? It is a loss to the economy. Why it is a loss to the economy? Because that asset is still lying. That capital is still lying unused. ठीक है, कभी litigation, कभी debt recovery tribunal में है, फिर छोटे court में आ गया, high court चला गया, फिर supreme court चले गए, finally supreme court से decision आया, पता चला 7-8 साल हो गए. वो asset आपका वैसा का वैसा ही पड़ा हुआ है. So just for this all purpose, what we need, thereby we are saying कि we need a bankruptcy court. We need a set of guidelines which are direct, which are speedy. Can we have a speedy time-bound resolution mechanism? Okay. So here what we are talking about, I think current problems we talked about. Here one point I want to highlight, in such a environment of legislative and judicial uncertainty, the outcomes on insolvency and bankruptcy are very poor. The World Bank in its report that the average time to resolve insolvency is 4 years in India, where as compared to 0.8 years in Singapore and 1 year in London. Okay. So again, it is a very important component also of ease of doing business, because jab aap ease of doing business uski website pe jaake dekhoge, there are a lot of indicators on the basis of that ease of doing business ka indicator aata hai. Okay. So it is also one of those indicators. Problem, I think we all discussed, there's a lack on clarity of jurisdiction, highly fragmented framework governed by multiple laws, inefficient and insufficient legal structure. Okay, so what are the options? How a modern law can help? Simple si baat hai, ki jo aapka paisa atka hua hai, if you can get that money back, then you could have that resource allocated for a productive use. Aap kahin bhi usko use kar sakte ho. Now, what the law that we are bringing, what are the salient features of the draft proposal? Low time to resolution, low loss in recovery. Ki one of the important component is that na ki jitni jaldi aap us asset ko dispose of kar doge, it would be that much valued. If it goes on or drags on for like 4 to 5 years, its value diminutes significantly. Okay. So it's very important ki as such you get an information ki we have to dispose of this assets. A company claimed bankruptcy and it has got huge debt obligations to the particular bank, then the bank is able to sell off those assets in first or second year to any competitor company. They could at least revive some of the amount. So the salient features of the new act, ab naya act kya bolega? Everything that you could think of, same, simple. कि हम एक रेगुलेटर बनाएंगे, हम एक इंसॉल्वेंसी एडजुकेटिंग अथॉरिटी बनाएंगे, उसके बाद वी विल हैव इंसॉल्वेंसी प्रोफेशनल्स विच वुड बी रजिस्टर्ड विद द अथॉरिटी, वी वुड हैव इंसॉल्वेंसी इंफॉर्मेशन यूटिलिटीज, द ड्राफ्ट बिल प्रेस्क्राइब्स अ स्विफ्ट प्रोसेस एंड टाइमलाइन ऑफ 180 डेज फॉर डीलिंग विद एप्लीकेशंस फॉर इंसॉल्वेंसी रेजोल्यूशन. इफ यू गो बैक टू द डॉक्यूमेंट दैट यू हैव इन योर हैंड, Page number 3. Yeah, second topic na. You could read the draft bankruptcy code. You will have a regulator at the apex. You will have an adjudicating authority which will decide the cases between the promoter and the bank. Then you will have a debt recovery tribunal, which would be the adjudicating authority. Insolvency professionals would be there. Matlab, there would be a dedicated class of personnel who would be undertaking such cases. There would be information utilities. And there is a time limit that you have to complete it in 6 months, 180 days. If not possible, then it could be extended for 90 days by the adjudicating authority. Matlab, simple si baat hai. Matlab, whatever problems that we have in NPA, theek hai. So this bankruptcy law, would be one of the step forward ki whoever company feels that they are not solvent, they could declare bankruptcy as happens in US, UK. You must have heard in UK, US, na? Donald Trump, who is the current presidential candidate, he has a lot of time said his companies a lot of time went bankrupt. A lot of time that happens. Okay, so once you have this law in place, at least you would have a mechanism to exit if you are not able to pay. At least bank will get something out of it. The economy, or you could say every actor which is there, they would be able to take a speedy decision, and the asset again will be made to be used in the economy as a purposeful asset.
Then
also it will happen. See, there are various chapters under which, for example, in US there are various chapters under which you could cite a reason why you are declaring bankrupt.
But we already had,
but that is not time bound. You have a lot of mechanism. Bhai, pehle aap debt recovery tribunal pe chale gaye, fir aap lower court pe chale gaye, fir aap higher court pe chale gaye. Here at least they are giving a designed performer. Theek hai. Further, they are creating professionals which could be used to tackle this particular issue. I think isme itna hi hai, matlab don't go too deep, don't go too technical, matlab no use. Moving to the next part, startup India, stand up India, like who all wants to start up? मतलब बैकअप यही सोच रखा होगा काफ़ी लोगों ने, नहीं सोचा? Nowadays everyone wants to do a startup. So startup India. Just some salient features, not much. Why Startup India? India ranks third among global startup ecosystem. Restarting private investment into the economy. Startups hold the potential of creating jobs. आप लोगों ने देखा होगा ना, Flipkart में कितनी jobs आ रही हैं, Snapdeal में jobs आ रही हैं, Zomato is like, now तो it's laying off, previously it was hiring a lot of people. Oyo Rooms is one such startup. So startups, you know, India is becoming a startup hub. A lot of venture capitalists, they are coming to India. They are investing money. Ola is one of the prime examples. I think most of you would be using that. So thereby, the government is trying to push this ecosystem. They are trying to create an ecosystem by which they are making everything comfortable for them. Ki if they have to, I think salient features we will come in the next slide. So first they want to, it's very difficult to define a startup, but the government came up with a definition. So please remember this definition, whoever are going for the interview. The action plan defines startup as an entity incorporated or registered in India not prior to 5 years, with annual turnover not exceeding 25 crore in any preceding financial year, working towards innovation, development, deployment or commercialization of new products, processes or services driven by technology or intellectual property. Theek hai, so whatever you could think of is there in the definition. Further, there are a number of features which the government came up so that there could have been ecosystem or jitne bhi regulatory hurdles etc to tone them down. For example, compliance regime is based on self certification. We would have a Startup India hub where all the people could come, they could talk etc. For example, in Kerala they came out with a hub where they are providing all the facilities. Matlab aisa ho gaya ki they are creating the infrastructure, you just have to go and set. for further patent protection there would be something. Further, they are saying that they will give 10,000 crore, 2,500 crore over 4 years. Okay, so these funds are not directly given to the startups. So here will be a startup, they will be funded by venture capitalists. And these venture capitalists will get this fund from the government of India, which is 10,000 crore. Now this is a criticism also, ki why taxpayers' money is given to something in which the risk is very high. If you see throughout the world, it is very few startups which have like incubated very very strongly, like Uber is one of them. Theek hai, but still this is a criticism ki 10,000 crore rupees aapne unko de diye, aapko pata nahi ki wo bechare bacche kya karenge kya nahi karenge. But for interview purpose, I think you could say no, we need to create this ecosystem, you know, we need jobs. Jobs will come from Startup India and Stand Up India. Exemption from capital gains tax, again not much of use, because capital gain tax exemption for startups, have you heard of any startup which is in positive in the first 3 years? Anyone? So again, whatever you could think of is here, setting up research parks, incubation centers, rebate, faster exit. Okay, I think one last topic that I would just go through, if you could open your handbook, there is this socio-economic caste census. Not much, there are two or three points which I would like to emphasize in that. See, you could if in the interview ask that how a scheme should be made, okay, like what should be the criteria of making a particular scheme, okay, or how leakages could be could be taken care of, okay. So one way you could say that, sir, we have now SECC data, okay, sir, it is a data which is based on certain criteria of inclusion and exclusion. On basis of this data, you could very specifically target sectors. You could specifically even target districts. That is, you won't say that in this district health is an issue. You could say in health also this particular issue should be a priority and we should give funds for this particular issue. Okay, so that is why this SECC 2011 data is very important. Still, the government has not provided caste data, but they have provided this socio-economic data. Here, for example, just giving an example, they have also a criteria like three or more rooms with pakka walls and roof. Now, if you know this data for all the districts of India, you could very well know that ki Indira Awas Yojana needs to be first implemented in which district. Which districts requires this particular policy of the government of India. Theek hai? So targeting, na, every time we say ki we should better target to reduce the leakages, okay, we should target. So SECC data could provide us with that information, which could provide us with that opportunity to target various sectors specifically, okay. But again, then currently what we are seeing is that a lot of researchers which are there on the ground, for example, a lot of researchers from prominent institutes, what they are saying is that a lot of data that we got from SECC, it is not matching their own ground based survey data, okay. So there is a criticism that the data is not as proof, it's not as sacrosanct that it has to be, because it is not matching with the other data that the government of India has or with people have. Further, it is also important because it is, I think, for the first time when we had a census in the rural India on the basis of such indicators. Okay, see the deprivation indicators: households, member, government employee, who owns a refrigerator, paying professional tax, paying income tax. I think this income tax, only I think 3% of rural India pays income tax. This is one of the reality which we got to know after having this census. So now whenever we talk about we should broad based our tax base, so we could think about how money could come from द रूरल इंडिया. फिर फाइव पैरामीटर्स ऑफ ऑटोमेटिक इंक्लूजन. फ्रॉम हेयर यू कुड नो दैट व्हाट आर द सोशल सेक्टर स्कीम्स विच यू नीड टू गिव इन अ पर्टिकुलर सेक्टर और इन अ पर्टिकुलर डिस्ट्रिक्ट ऑफ द कंट्री. सो मे बी लाइक वेर एवर यू आर योर ओन डिस्ट्रिक्ट यू कुड गो एंड फाइंड. आई थिंक दैट शुड बी अवेलेबल ऑन द इंटरनेट. यू कुड फाइंड दैट व्हाट आर द इंडिकेटर्स ऑफ योर डिस्ट्रिक्ट. ठीक है. एंड देन मे बी इफ इन इंटरव्यू मेनी टाइम्स यू आस्क अ क्वेश्चन दैट व्हाट आर द प्रॉब्लम्स ऑफ योर डिस्ट्रिक्ट. ठीक है. तो ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ दिस इंडिकेटर्स यू कुड टेल देम कि सर दिस आर द प्रॉब्लम्स ऑफ माई डिस्ट्रिक्ट एंड वी नीड टू टैकल दिस प्रॉब्लम बाई हैविंग दिस मेजर्स. अदर देन दैट आई थिंक जस्ट हैव अ रीड अबाउट दिस डेटा. नॉट मच. So I think that's all from my side. We will have a 10 to 15 minutes break. After this, Jatin sir will come and take the rest of the issues further. This is my email ID. If anyone of you wants to have any query, you could mail me here. mayank.a@visionis.in. I would be available outside for like next few hours. If anyone of you have any doubt, you could come. Thank you.